Hello everyone, welcome to VLSI Academy. This is our first video and we will begin with defining the variables in Perl. There are three types of variables in Perl. Broadly speaking, it is array, scalar and hashes. We will see the difference between them in further videos. Let's see how to define the scalars first. As we explained it earlier too, that every scalar must begin with a dollar. This is how Perl compiler understands the variable type. So this is how a string assignment is done. This is how strings are defined, and this is how an integer is defined, and this is how a floating point number will be defined. So if you want to print them, so you can print them on a screen using this code. So print age is equal to dollar employee age. So with this dollar, this will understand that it has to print this scalar variable value. So employee age will be 23, so it will print 23. Employee name is Sagar, it will print name is equal to Sagar. Salary is equal to dollar employee underscore salary, so it will print 440 point type, that is a floating point number. So everything it will take on its own. So the output will look something like this. Now let's move on to defining array variable types in Perl. An array is a variable that stores an ordered list of scalar values. Array variables are preceded by at, unlike dollar in scalar in case of Perl. So let's see how to define the arrays. At names is equal to Mohan, Ekansh and Hina. So these are the values of array elements which are stored in the array which has a name of names. So array name is names. Let's see another type of array. Here age is the name of array and these are values. So 0th index contains 25, 1st index contains 28, 2nd index contains 31. So if you want to print them in a code, how will you print? So this is how you can print them. Print and then slash dollar ages of 0 is equal to dollar ages of 0. So this will give you first value that is at the 0th index in the array of ages. So this 25 will be printed in this case, and ages of 1 will print 28 and ages of 2 will print 31. So here dollar of ages means it is a scalar value. So to access each element of an array, you have to use dollar. But if you want to define an entire array, then you have to use at ages. So this is how you can access the array elements. So if you want to print in the command line, this is how it will look like. So here this backslash of dollar, it will escape this sequence and it will print the dollar as it is instead of printing the array value. But here there is no escape sequence, so it will understand that it has to print the value of this variable. Now let's move on to defining hashes in Perl. A hash is a set of key value pairs. It is nothing but an associative array. In normal arrays, we access value using its index. But in hash, we access the value using its keys. Hash variables are preceded by a percentage sign in Perl. So this is how you define the hash in a Perl. So emp underscore data, this is a hash name. Then Danish, 28. So Danish is the key, value is 28. Raju is the key and then value is 40. Dritesh is a key and 25 is the value. So key value, key value, key value. This is how you define your hash. To access the hash, you have to print them like this. So data of Danish, this is the key. Data of Danish will give you the value that will be 28. We access value of hash very similar to the way we access the value in normal array. But instead of index, we have to specify the key for which you want to get the value. Output of this particular code will look something like this. So here dollar data of Danish is equal to 28. This dollar data of Danish is evaluated and this corresponding key will give this value. This corresponding Raju is the key for which the value is 40, so that will be printed. And again then Ritesh is the key and 25 is the value. But here if you notice this backslash, it will again serve as an escape sequence. So this dollar is printed as it is and this will be not evaluated. But here there is no escape sequence and it will be evaluated properly. This is how it is. We will cover more concepts in further videos. Please like and share the video and subscribe to the channel. And don't forget to put your valuable feedback in the comment section. Thank you.